Hey there, DJ Blaze here, and today we'll be reacting to apparently a real-life Battle Royale Squid Game. I have no clue what it is, but if y'all know what Battle Royale or Squid Game is, you know, maybe this might seem familiar to you. Let me know down in the comment section below if you think so. And yeah, but if you like this video, make sure to drop a like to let me know. And of course, I'm subscribed if you'd like to, you know, see more content just like this. And without further ado, let's get right into the video.
Today's video is brought to you by our sponsor, NordPlan, plus one additional month with a NordVPN. Have you ever received a suspicious link or accidentally opened up a web page that creates an content NordVPN throttling? Go to nordvpn.com/simplehistory and get it. The real-life Battle Royale, Nazina, Russia, 1933. On May 18, 1933, on the direct orders of Stalin himself, 5,000 men and women arrived at Nazina, a small isolated island on the river
Isn't this before World War II?
In the remote and barren wilderness of Western Siberia. Within a matter of weeks, 4,000 of them would either just die from exposure, disappear, drown, or be eaten. This was the real-life Battle Royale. The Soviet Union was a miserable place to live during this period, with severe food shortages which resulted in millions of people dying of starvation.
That's actually pretty bad.
Any form of criticism of the state was dealt with brutally, where the offender would probably get a life sentence and be sent to a gulag, where they would literally be worked to death carrying out hard labor. Stalin's purge of the so-called socially harmful elements of society mainly concentrated on certain groups, such as the Cossacks, ethnic minorities, intellectuals, and the kulaks, who were peasants who owned their own land and were sometimes hesitant in contributing a share of their goods to the common collective. Even the armed forces were not exempt, as mass purges were commonplace, which normally resulted in the execution of its most experienced officers.
Wow, that's actually kind of sad, isn't it?
Included a wide cross-section of urban society, not just criminals and vagrants, but also regular workers, children, and pensioners. Many were taken simply because they had failed to obtain an internal passport.
Starting out with any new project management software usually feels something like this.
However, others included a party member who had stepped out of her apartment without her party card, a worker buying cigarettes who had left his passport at home, a 12-year-old girl waiting at a train station while her mother bought bread, as well as the pregnant wife of a naval officer and a 103-year-old man. None of them were pioneers ready to settle and farm a harsh and unforgiving land. In February 1933, the head of the secret police, Genrikh Yagoda, and the head of the Gulag labor camp system, Matvey Berman, got together and approached Stalin with a plan to resettle 2 million of these people into what was thought to be the vast area of untapped natural resources in Siberia and Kazakhstan. However, the environment was harsh and extremely cold, and much of the area was tundra and frozen all year round. Even when it did thaw out in the summer, the ground became swampy and infertile and unsuitable for any kind of agriculture. To add to this, the air would have been thick with mosquitoes. One of the areas that was chosen for the project was Nazina Island, which was on the north bank of the Ob River, deep inside the Siberian wilderness. The island was only ever visited by the local Ostyak people from the nearby village of Nazina to gather tree bark to use as firewood. It was relatively small, measuring just 2 miles or about 3.2 kilometers long and 650 yards or 595 meters wide, and mostly made up of inhospitable swampland. Hunting and foraging was going to be nearly impossible. Many thousands of the so-called undesirables, which also included hardened and petty criminals by now, were being held in overcrowded prisons in Moscow and Leningrad. So, in the spring of 1933, they were loaded into all sorts of railway carriages, which included cattle trucks, and began a 10-day journey to Tomsk, where the half-completed transit camps were waiting for them. During the journey, gangs of criminals systematically beat up and robbed their fellow passengers.
That's
May 14th, 1933, after the prisoners had been processed and selected, 5,000 of these settlers set off on their journey to Nazina Island. They were loaded onto river barges that had only been designed to carry timber down the River Orb and were only given 200 grams of bread each a day for the 5-day journey. By the time they had arrived at Nazina, 30 people had died on the barges, and a third of them were too weak to even stand. The authorities had failed to provide any form of shelter on the island, nor any basic tools or building materials to construct basic shelters against the elements. On their first night there, it snowed heavily, and almost 300 people had frozen to death by the morning from exposure. This happened every night, and some people were actually burned alive from laying too close to the campfires that they had made to try to keep themselves warm.
Wow.
20 tons of flour had been left on the island for the settlers, but straight away fights broke out when guards tried to distribute it daily, and they ended up firing at the mob to break them up. As no ovens were available there to make bread or anything else, the settlers either ate the flour raw or mixed it with dirty water from the river, and this led to an outbreak of dysentery.
Wow.
Daily fighting soon broke out over whatever resources were still available, and killings became commonplace, and the bodies were robbed of any possessions they had, including money and especially gold fillings and crowns from their mouths. To add
That's
to
really
all
that.
This misery, 9 days later another 1,200 settlers arrived on the island, and very quickly groups of rival gangs started to form, and murder and extortion became commonplace. In desperation, many of the settlers tried to construct crude rafts out of pieces of wood that they could find to flee the island, but they were so basic that they were not fit for purpose and they just sank. So they simply drowned in the ice-cold river and their bodies were washed up on the shore along the River Orb. If they did manage to reach the opposite bank of the river alive, the guards would go and hunt them down for sport, and no questions were ever asked as to what had happened to them. Because of the lack of sanitation, there was soon an outbreak of typhus, which many succumbed to because of their already weak state of health. But far worse was to come, because within a week, a doctor discovered cases of cannibalism beginning to appear on the island, as people became desperate to find something to eat. It started out with cutting slices of flesh from the dead corpses and cooking them, but then progressed to killing people who were so weak or were so close to death, and therefore so vulnerable and unable to defend themselves. When one survivor was asked if he had eaten human flesh while on the island, he replied that he had only eaten livers and hearts, and then only from people who were dying anyway. Another incident involved a young woman who was having a relationship with one of the guards. When he was not around to protect her, some men tied her to a tree, killed her, and cut off everything from her body that they could eat.
Oh.
Despite the many arrests and executions by the guards, the situation was brought under control when, after a damning internal report was submitted, it was decided to abandon the settlement on Nazina Island only after a month after it had been set up. Approximately one-third of the settlers had died, while another third were reported as missing, possibly escaped, drowned,
literally.
Just over 2,000 people had survived. Unknown to the settlers at the time, all of their hardships had been in vain, as back in Moscow there had been a change in policy, and Stalin and the authorities had decided to cancel the whole settler experiment program. There was an official investigation into the Nazina incident, but the findings were never made public at the time. Several local officials and guards were given short prison sentences or dismissed from office. In the mid-1980s, the human rights group Memorial made the details of their findings public after they had investigated the episode themselves. A memorial cross was placed on the island in 1993 to remember those who had lost their lives there.
The
inscription on its plaque reads, "To the victims of political repression, 1933 to 1993. And every June, the local villagers from Nazina cross the river and place a wreath on the memorial.
Man, this is just sad. But anyways, yeah, wow, I wasn't expecting the real life battle royale and Squid Game to be so, yeah, to be so like gruesome and like, so like, what the fuck, like, you know. But yeah, I guess this is life like in the Soviet Union in the past, so yeah. But anyways, if you like the video so far, make sure to drop me a like to let me know. And of course, you know, subscribe if you like to help support the channel completely for free. Last but not least, thank you all so much for watching. Make sure to drop by my Twitch streams over at twitch.tv/tdhplays. And I hope to see you in the next video or in the next stream.